This 87-year-old female lady was remitted with a subluxated nucleus on one eye and a subluxated IOL on the other eye. I will show here the surgery of the subluxated IOL. Insert 325 gauge trocars 3.5 millimeter behind the limbus and then perform a limbal peritomy at 12 o'clock. Dissect the conjunctival tissue with tenon from the sclera. Then, if necessary, cauterize the bleeding vessels. Then take the caliper and mark 6 millimeter on the sclera. This incision can be parallel or a smiley. Take a 15 degrees knife and make an incision which is 6 millimeter wide. Then dissect the sterile tissue with a crescent bevel up knife. This is an important step, this dissection. This is the perfect depth. You see the knife shining through the tissue. Take then a 2.75 blade and open the anterior chamber. As already said, it's a U-shaped incision, not a V-shaped incision. It's a U-shaped incision. This is the viscoelastic cannula. Injecting viscoelastics behind the IOL. The IOL is extracted with an intravitreal forceps called serrated jaws forceps. If you look carefully, you can also see the capsular tension ring and the haptic. Little bit more viscoelastic into the anterior chamber. Grasp the haptic and pull out the IOL. A bit more difficult due to the capsular tension ring. I'm removing now the capsular tension ring. I think it's a Sioni ring. And finally, the IOL is removed. Insertion of an infusion line. You can also use an anterior chamber infusion line and an anterior vitrectomy from pars plana. You don't need a biome. It's important that you see the tip of the vitreous cutter if you perform vitrectomy. I'm trying to remove a vitreous strand at 1 o'clock. Observe the ectopic pupil. If you see such a pupil, you must suspect a vitreous strand. But I cannot find a vitreous strand, and the pupil is still ectopic, a bit unusual. I'm checking again from the temporal side, but I cannot find a vitreous strand. I continue with an anterior vitrectomy. The tip should be seen during vitrectomy. If you go along the edge of the pupil, you're on the safe side. Then inject acetylcholine myocol into the anterior chamber in order to constrict the pupil. I'm trying now to fix the ectopic pupil, paracentesis at 6 o'clock, insertion of an intervitreal forceps, and then grasping the ectopic part of the pupil and repositioning of the pupil. Now comes the iris claw IOL. It has to be upside down. It fits nicely into the incision. 6 millimeter is perfect. The next step is the proper centration of the IOL. This is a rotator, comes with the AMO instrument set. You can also use the iris spatula, but I think it is easier with the rotator. Now again with the rotator, centration of the IOL. This is the IOL forceps, also included in the AMO instrument pack. Flip the IOL behind the iris and enclave the iris tissue with the iris spatula. Gorda has a special instrument for this maneuver, and the same side on the other side. Try to keep the IOL forceps steady in order to prevent iris trauma. Inflate the globe and suture the sterile incision with a cross stitch, Vicryl 8-0. The stitch only needs to be form stable. Don't pull it tight in order to avoid an astigmatism. Don't pull strongly now. The stitch must only be form stable so that the incision is watertight. Don't pull too strong in order to avoid an astigmatism. The next step is the closure of the conjunctiva with a simple non-interrupted Vicryl 8-0 stitch on both sides. Remove then the trocars. First the two instrument trocars, and of course in the end the infusion trocar, so that you have infusion on the eye as long as possible. And finally, inject BSS in order to extract the viscoelastics. Thank you very much.